Moving on to maybe one that I'm sure that Anthony knows. Danny Garcia versus Sean Porter. Being eye for September 8th at the Barclays Center in New York. It seems like it's finally getting a date. David Benavidez versus Anthony Dirrell being talked about as the co-main for it. Fantastic fight. Fantastic doubleheader, I would say, as well. Finally glad they're putting a date to this. You know, not really much to talk about because it's sort of been rumored for a long time. But we have a date. September 8th, Barclays Center. Be there. Be there for the live fight chat when it happens. Anthony, as a casual like boxing fan, where does this fight rank to you in terms of interest?
Very, very interesting. I mean, Danny Garcia has always been a great fighter to watch. Sean Porter repeatedly finds himself in exciting fights. I mean, I still have chills thinking about the Keith Thurman fight. Mm-hmm. That was an excellent fight. The Adrian Broner fight was another highlight for me as well. Both of those guys together, they can make fireworks. I mean, Danny Garcia too. He's not shy of being in an exciting fight himself. I mean, right off the top of my head, the Lamont Peterson fight comes to mind. That was a barn burner right there. So I don't see how this isn't entertaining. Off the top of my head, I probably want to favor Garcia to win.
Interesting.
But
why?
But he seems to be the more consistent guy. He just seems more consistent to me. He doesn't have the power that Porter does. But I see him being able to land the more consistent shots and at least maintain enough distance to not get too hit up himself. So, I could be wrong on that.
No, you know, I'll put it this way. I've gone on the record saying I'm picking Danny Garcia to win, and that's not the consensus pick. Like most people, I would say in the boxing community, in the media, in the fandom, are picking Sean Porter based off of his activity, his volume, his aggression. Danny Garcia, not being the most active guy, can tend to be outboxed at times, or at least outfought, I would say, at times. But, yeah, you know, things that you mentioned, I think Danny Garcia will be able to land the cleaner shots throughout because he has better timing, he has better accuracy. Sean Porter, even though an entertaining, exciting fighter, is not the most accurate guy. He swarms his own shots to where they're ineffective. I think Danny will be able to counter him throughout the fight, be able to win rounds, win a tight decision, but definitely a close, fun fight, one that I'm glad casuals are sort of picking up on, so to speak. It's definitely one of those that I think because like there's been really no like media push for it. Like you don't see Sean Porter and Danny Garcia on social media talking about it, like pushing for it. It feels sort of underwhelming to me, but hopefully the names of these guys is enough to sort of translate to casual interest. But I think they should put some money behind this because I don't think Danny and Sean are the best self promoters in the game, I would say.
Definitely, just keep Danny Garcia's dad away from any camera, and yeah, we might be on to something positive.
No. See, here's the thing: you put Danny's dad and Sean's dad in the same room, and that's all you need. Just put all the cameras on them. Because Ken Porter is something else, man. First off, that guy at his age is still picking up the finest women out there in Vegas. Salute to him. Salute to him, man. God. Way to go for Ken Porter. But Ken can talk some shit, man. Like even though Angel Garcia is a crazy cocaine addict racist, it doesn't matter. Ken's going to talk some shit. So I'm hyped for that at least. I'll be honest.
That's the key. Just throw a camera in front of them and consequences of society be damned. We're going to have a fight.
That's true. And David Benavidez, Anthony Dirrell, fun fight. David Benavidez should be the favorite though. Anthony Dirrell being, I think, the better Dirrell brother overall, being more durable, but still not an elite guy. One of those perennial top five guys who if you beat him, you are elite. You are truly elite. If you don't, you can still be really good, and if he trashes you, you don't belong anywhere in the conversation in boxing. But fun fight at the top right there. And also another sign that David Benavidez is not with Top Rank, that he sort of had to recant all that, give the signing bonus back to Top Rank because he did sort of breach his contract.